Hello everyone, my name is André Lahaye. In this video, I'm going to show you where you can find information on unitary patents, also named European Patents with Unitary Effect, in the European Patent Bulletin. The introduction of the unitary patent in June 2023 created new data which you can find in the European Patent Office's patent information tools and products. This is shown schematically in this overview. On this infographic, you can see that the European Patent Bulletin contains information on all steps in the life of a unitary patent, with the exception of UPC cases records. Let's have a closer look at the European Patent Bulletin. The European Patent Bulletin is one of the important official publications of the EPU. It contains records with the bibliographic data and legal status of all newly published European patent applications and patents, as well as recent changes to previously published patents under the European Patent Convention. The bulletin is published weekly on Wednesdays in PDF format and in the three official languages of the EPU. The publication date of the bulletin is in many cases the date on which a published event has legal effect. Let's download, for example, the European Patent Bulletin of the 2nd of August 2023. Since the launch of the Unitary Patent System, the European Patent Bulletin also publishes a dedicated chapter for the Unitary Patent, the so-called Chapter 4. If you go down in the introduction part A, you will see this new chapter and its 12 main sections listed. You will certainly have noticed that some sections are in bold. This means that under these sections, you will see records in the current bulletin issue. Section 411, for example, publishes the date of filing of the requests for unitary effect. You can see many entries in the publication of the 2nd of August. A request for unitary effect must be filed no later than 1 month after the mention of the grant of the European patent in the bulletin. If the period for filing a request for unitary effect was missed, there is still an option to file a request for re-establishment of rights. The date of receipt of this request and the decision will be published in sections 481 and 2. Section 412 is about the date of withdrawal of request for unitary effect. Withdrawal of the request can be done as long as no decision has been taken by the EPU, which means either the registration of the unitary effect or the rejection of the request. The date of the registration is provided in section 421. There are many such records in the bulletin of the 2nd of August. Among other criteria, the eligibility for registration requires, for example, that the European patent has been granted with the same set of claims in respect of all participating member states, and that the required translations have been provided in due time. If the request for unitary effect is rejected, the date of the rejection will be published in section 422. Section 45 concerns one important date, the date of lapse of the unitary patent. We have, of course, no entries in the bulletin of the 2nd of August under this section. In sections 471, 2 and 3, you will find amended B documents and reprints of corrected B documents with unitary effect. You can see some entries for reprints of B documents in the bulletin of the 2nd of August. Unitary patent proprietors can file a statement that they are prepared to allow any person to use their invention via a license. They can also withdraw this statement. The dates for filing or withdrawal of these statements are published in section 411, 1 and 2. You can see here one record under section 411, 1. Unitary patents may be licensed in respect of the whole or part of the territories of the participating member states. Section 411(3) and 4 are reserved for this information. And finally, Section 412 is about corrected, changed, or deleted entries. For example, new patent representatives for the unitary patent, or new unitary patent proprietors after a transfer of rights. I have only shown you some of the sections which you can find in the European Patent Bulletin with regards to the unitary patent, but I encourage you to have a look at all available sections which are listed in Introduction Part A of the Bulletin, as well as some supplementary details in Part D. Should you have any question on this topic, don't hesitate to contact us at this link on the EPO website, mentioning that your question concerns the Bulletin. We will answer your question as soon as possible. Well, that's it for now. Thanks for watching and have a great day.